While the nation is engrossed in the presidential contest, Kentucky voters, pundits, and politicians also have their eyes on another prize, control of the Kentucky House of Representatives. There are 53 Democrats and 47 Republicans in the lower chamber. Democratic House Speaker Greg Stumbo doesn't fear an upset.
If we think about voter registration in Kentucky, Democrats still have an edge, although that is slimming. Republicans are making some gains over recent years. Our constitutional officer lineup has grown more Republican. You know very well there have been a couple of switches in the House from Dems to Republicans, and many people would say that shows...
We're going to get those back.
All right, I want you to answer that, but many people would say that that shows there's a great weakness in the Kentucky Democratic Party.
Well, I don't know that there's a weakness in the Kentucky Democratic Party. The whole South has trended Republican for a number of years, and, you know, we're part of much of our heritage. It trends back to Southern values and those sorts of things. I think I see that changing.
Mm-hmm.
I think people are waking up to this idea that, you know, people who are radicals don't need to be in charge of government. People who have hot tempers, people who won't obey the rules, people who believe that that they're an emperor and not an elected official and just want to do things their way regardless of what the law says. I think people are waking up to that, and that's going to be our message this fall.
The Prestonsburg Democrat believes government functions best from the middle, not by what he calls fringe elements on either side. He says the core values of the Democratic Party are solid, and so, he enthuses, are his House candidates.
I like our team. Our team is excited. We've got some great new candidates for some of these vacant seats. We've got two good candidates against the two that decided to change and break the vow that they made when they signed their papers and swore that they would uphold the principles of the party that they were elected from. And I like our chances. I really do. You know, we're not going to be able to raise as much money. We never do. Everybody always says, well, they're going to outraise. Well, they always do outraise us.
Mm-hmm.
But money's like snow. Once it gets over your knee, snow, don't matter how deep it gets, you know, you're stuck. So money's the same way. We don't have to get it up to our thigh. We just have to get it to where we can be competitive. And usually that's a, they usually hold in money raising about a, you know, 25 point edge over us.
Mm-hmm.
But we prevail because we have a better message and we have candidates who deliver that message better.
So Speaker Stumbo, are you gonna run less against Donald Trump and more against Matt Bevin?
You can take that to the bank. We're gonna make this a referendum on Matt Bevin. And I think you're going to find, as we did find in the special elections, that people don't have a generally high opinion of him. But, yeah, we're going to run against Matt Bevin and Matt Bevin's record and Matt Bevin's ideas and his desire to be an emperor, his desire not to follow the rule of law. And I think people are generally receptive to... That's where the balance of government comes in. They do want to see some balance.
I welcome Greg Stumbo running on that. Of course, he cannot run on his support for Hillary Clinton and her agenda, so he has to find something else, and we welcome that. What I hear is people like someone who's shaking it up. You know,
even though his approval ratings may say otherwise.
Yeah, but when I talk to people, they like someone who has come in, who is shaking things up.
Hoover believes the policy contrasts between Hillary Clinton and Donald Trump are obvious, especially when it comes to coal. Hoover says on that issue alone, Trump has the upper hand with voters in the bluegrass.
Do you think he's going to help in Kentucky, and you probably do, all the way down the ballot, and particularly help you in your quest to take over the House from the Democrats?
I think he will. If you go back and look in presidential election years, go back to 2012, 2008, 2004, Republicans in the Kentucky House have always gained seats. We've always won seats in a presidential election year because Kentucky traditionally votes Republican.
How are you hoping now, with all the dynamics going on, and even with your own set of candidates, that you're going to be able to flip the House this time?
Well, some interesting numbers. First of all, out of 100 seats, we have 91 Republicans on the ballot. That is a record number of Republicans running for the state house. We have, I think, 27 incumbent Republicans that are unopposed. There are only 9 incumbent Democrats that are unopposed. And then you go back and look at Matt Bevin's election in 2015, Renee. He carried 106 out of 120 counties. But interestingly, he carried 26 House districts that are currently occupied by a Democrat. In 2014, we only had 13 candidates in those particular 26 districts that Matt Bevin carried. In 2016, we got 24 candidates out of those 26 districts. So we are much more competitive. You look at the money raised, cash on hand, at the end of June, Republican Party of Kentucky had 1.6 million. Kentucky Democrat Party had 72,000. We feel really good about our fundraising efforts. We feel really good about our candidates. So we're excited about these next 97 or 98 mm-hmm. days, whatever it is, before the election.
Hoover says the House Republican caucus supports his ascension to Speaker, contrary to publicized reports, if the GOP flips the House. If attempts to wrest control from the Democrats fail again this time, Leader Hoover says he'll pass the baton.
I've been fighting this battle since 2001 when I was first elected Republican leader. At that time, I think we had 35 members. And so now to get to 47, the most in almost 100 years, for me, this is sort of the final quarter. We're going to win, and hopefully I will be Speaker, and I expect to be Speaker. Or if we don't, then I fully intend not to run for leader again, and I'll return in a couple of years to full-time law practice.
Really? So you're saying that should it not flip, mm-hmm. you would not seek the minority leader position?
That's correct. I've told our caucus that.
As it's often said in Frankfurt, elections have consequences. That expression resonates from the White House to the State House.